first shown here 2 years ago. This is the bottom news. Are you going to talk about it? Just the files?
Well,
I can help within the department. You took one afterwards, or something?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Really easy. And before he was here, he gave us a demonstration and it's an instrument which responds to electrical activity in muscles. But tonight's going to be used to control video. The second piece, the first piece, however, is a student, Ryan Hay, the cognize at ACA. He's going to do something much more low level. Equally interesting. I'll check with them and see if I should say anything like that. But for now, Ricardo Arnes. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. this case, forming two pieces that are still controlling synthesizers, based on synthesizers, but now also controlling moving images under same gestural control. So pieces that are on the program are called Overgo and Terra. I'll in fact be performing them in reverse order, Terra first and then Overgo. They're both pieces created for this on the system. And to describe it briefly, we can say that muscle tension signals here from my forearms and upper arm are captured as MIDI signals into the piece which resides in the computer. This piece then, or the software for that piece, dispatches the information from these gestures to the sound synthesizers, and that same information gets dispatched to a second computer which these images being projected on the screen. So, in fact, this is a controllable image, but not a video image, in fact. The source materials here, much in the way that I prepare sounds on the synthesizer, I prepare still images that are in this program, program called Leaf Audio, created by a friend of mine. It's a program called,
in fact, it's not dealing with video images at all, it's dealing with still images, a bank of up to 16 of them. So these are each piece has different bank of images that I prepared for that piece. And what happens is that the program is able to put these images into motion, to create a dynamic fluid motion of these images by using image processing algorithms that are under control, under MIDI control. So that's to say from the gestures. So if I have a movement that I'm creating, is at once the same movement, the single movement can at once control the sound of the image. Well, so much for the wiring diagram part of the presentation. One thing that struck me as I was watching Ricardo's performance, in fact, is a kind of similarity and a big difference. But no, I think, well, I was remarking how some of the sound that I'm starting to try to use in the synthesizer in some ways resemble the sounds that are used in both his balloons. And I think the striking thing about his instrument, you know, is the contact, because the physics, the touch, the tactile feedback that is so obvious that he has. This is what I think is satisfying for him as a performer and for us to watch. My instrument comes from another era of technology when everyone was caught up, worried about and talking about virtual things, things that don't have so much contact, tactile feedback. And in fact, that very issue became a big concern for me. So what I started to try to do with this instrument then, since this instrument gives me no tactile feedback, there is nothing to touch, there's nothing to hold, there's nothing to fight against me, I still sought to find that in some way, because this is one of the essential satisfactions of these originally these instrumentals, traditional instruments have our instruments. So in creating these pieces, I was looking for a dynamic where somehow out of this system, even without a physical object there, that I was getting some kind of feedback from the system, some kind of tactile response. It took some effort, it took some physicality involved. So what's interesting to me is some of the sound that I was thinking of and creating somehow are something similar to Ricardo's breakdowns.
There was a conference this weekend about dance and media. Mm-hmm. We were talking about virtual reality, about how popular is virtual reality because of lack of contact. But one issue that came up was the idea of a proprioceptive sense, a sense of your own body, which dancers are very aware of. In a sense, that's one of the things we do have feedback.
That's right.
Totally. How does that work?
And that's, well, that is very, very true. And in fact, that made the violinist for me a more interesting, quote unquote, virtual instrument than, let's say, a data drum. because well, in fact, a data glove is a physically external device that you sort of wear and manipulate. It's not so great in tactile feedback, in fact. This bionics comes out of a similar era in technology, but had an interesting difference for me. It's no longer an external device. It is really taking electrical signals from the body. So the tactile feedback comes from within, in fact, and it's the effort of the fatigue that I encounter in trying to perform these cases that become the resistance, so forth. That's true. Some of these other human cases may not provide so well. So that's exactly the issue I'm very, very interested in, to see how this interactive interface technology, how that can start to give us the kind of satisfaction that we know from older technology. And that's something that we've had, well, it's often missing, it's like maths, or data graph, or whatever. So those are some of the issues I think as I work on this music. So let's start with Terra. Terra is good to start with because, in fact, it goes through three sections where you see certain mappings of an association of sound and sort of source images and different sections of like a very, very common type. You see natural type of numbers into the keyboard, you just page from one section to another. And over vocals, that can sum up a little bit more.
Okay.
time.